Ciao, everybody. Welcome to my home. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today I'm going to be making a very special dinner. A friend of mine is here from Hong Kong and she's here just for the day. So it's just her and myself. And I'm going to be making meatballs with polenta. Now I know that a lot of you think that Italians eat meatballs with spaghetti, but actually we don't. That's a North American thing. We love it with polenta. Now let's get started. Okay, we're gonna start with the meatballs. Here I have 500 grams of veal and 500 grams of beef. Now you can do a third of everything with a third of pork, but my girlfriend Jennifer doesn't eat pork, so we're just gonna do beef and veal. Okay, I'm just doing a nice mix of the two meats. Okay, I'm going to start with 1¾ cup of seasoned Italian breadcrumbs. A cup of grated pecorino cheese. Okay, now would be a really good time to preheat your oven at 400 degrees. Now, I prefer my meatballs baked. That's just the way I prefer them. But I know that a lot of you prefer to fry them. Sure, you can fry them if you like. Half a cup of Parmigiano Reggiano. Now I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of kosher salt. Okay, half a teaspoon of black pepper. I'm going to add 2 eggs. I'm going to scramble them first before I add them. I'm going to add 3/4 cups of red wine. Or garlic cloves minced. Now, if you like hot, for example, if you'd like to add chili peppers or something, now would be the time to add it, but I'm not going to add any. Here I have 3 tablespoons of fresh chopped parsley. Okay, so my meatball is ready here. Now, I'm going to use a 1-inch scooper because that's the size of meatball I like. You can go bigger, or you can do a 2-inch, you can do a 1/2 inch, whatever you like. Now, if I were to do a soup, I would use the smaller one. But for the polenta, 1 inch is good. So I'm just going to go in, a little bit bigger, and I'm going to roll it, and then I'm going to pat it with olive oil and on my baking dish. Okay, so I rolled the olive oil in my hands when I was rolling it. I'm just going to touch them ever so gently on top with olive oil because I'm going to be roasting them. So in the oven they go for 30 minutes. My kitchen smells like heaven and my meatballs are ready. Now that my meatballs are done, I can start with the polenta. I have 4 cups of chicken stock. I'm adding 2 minced garlic cloves to my chicken broth. Okay, I'm just going to mix it and bring it to a boil. The last time Jennifer was here, I was also alone that day, and we were up until 4:30 in the morning watching Gilmore Girls and talking and eating junk food, and we had a wonderful time. And the reason why she left at 4:30 was because she had a 7 o'clock flight. Okay, so my stock is boiling. Now I put it down to medium heat and I'm going to add the cornmeal. And continuously stir while you're adding the cornmeal. That's 1 cup of cornmeal. 1 tablespoon of kosher salt. 1 teaspoon of black pepper. Now it's very important that you don't stop stirring. You just keep stirring because you don't want any lumps. My polenta's ready. I've been mixing and mixing and mixing and it's ready. Now I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. Okay, turn off your stove. My polenta's ready. I'm going to add 1/2 cup of creme fraiche. I love the creme fraiche in the polenta. Finally, 1 cup of Parmigiano Reggiano. And your polenta is ready. It's ready. Look how beautiful and creamy. I'm just going to taste it. party. This is actually our comfort food. I have my marinara sauce, very basic. It's just heating up, and now I'm going to plate. Jennifer's on her way. By the time I finish plating, she should be here. Okay. Oh. Oh, doesn't that look wonderful? Add a little bit of marinara sauce. Just a little bit. Add the meatballs. This is an absolutely wonderful dish. This brings me back to my childhood. I hope you will try this recipe, and it's catarina.